Your pelvic floor isn't broken. There's nothing wrong with your pelvic floor. It's just not working as it should. And your pelvic floor is a tag-along to your breathing. As your diaphragm lifts and lowers, your pelvic floor lifts and lowers with it. It's a tensioning, a slight tensioning and a slight relaxation. And all the time, your pelvic floor is working to lift all of your organs. So it's never really off, except when you're completely lying down. And if your breathing is off and you're not creating good abdominal pressure, your pelvic floor can't function. And that's where pelvic floor dysfunction comes from. Not from pelvic floor being broken or a pelvic floor being too this or too that, but your breathing being off and the pelvic floor having nothing that's functioning to hang on to so that it can then work. So you fix your breathing and you fix this intrinsic core system and your pelvic floor can tag along and be functional. So let's have a look at breathing and how it should actually work. As you breathe in, your diaphragm should lower, and so should your pelvic floor, just slightly, just relax. And then as you breathe out, your breath out should be much longer than your breath in, and your pelvic floor tensions as your diaphragm lifts. So we want to practice having a diaphragm that moves, and we want to practice having sides that move, and a belly that moves. And if all of those are moving well, then we can move lower and we can move kind of below the nicker line. And that should also move. And if it is moving, then there's a very good chance that the pelvic floor is moving as well. But if these are not moving, then pelvic floor won't be moving. So if you breathe and your shoulders lift up and down, or if you breathe and it's all in your upper chest, then you're discounting all of that lower part of your body and your pelvic floor isn't moving in and out with every breath. And what we're looking for to fix our pelvic floor is just to allow our pelvic floor to work. So we make our breath, we allow our breath to go down into the lower part of our abdomen so that our pelvic floor has a system to tag onto. To practice your breathing, start by putting your hands on your lower rib cage where your diaphragm is. And just see if you can get your ribs to flare in and out as you breathe. They should move in and out as you breathe. And then once you've got the breathing in there, then you want to go lower. Your tummy should go in and out as you breathe. And it should really round as you breathe in. And then it should come together nice and evenly as you breathe out. Then you put your hands on your sides and you want the sides of your waist, the sides of your stomach to go in and out as you breathe. And then put your hands just either side of your pubic bone where there's a dip on each side. And you're trying to get your breath into and definitely out of there. And your breath out should evacuate from the bottom up so that you feel that there's a kind of pulling in as you breathe out, but it's not a pulling in that you have made, it's a pulling in that the evacuation of your breath has created. That's what we call our intra-abdominal pressure, and that's what makes us strong, and that's what looks after our low spine and the rest and our pelvic stability. When your breathing is off, the best way to practice this is to be lying on your back. So if you lie on your back with your feet up against the wall or your feet on a chair, then there's no pressure on your pelvic floor at all. You haven't got your organs on top of it. So that's the best position to practice good breathing, because in that position you can really just work on your breath and your pelvic floor can tag along with only its movement that needs to happen. It doesn't have to do any lifting at the same time. Keeping your stomach slightly pulled in all the time works against this breathing process. So try and keep a relaxed tummy, just keep nice and tall with your ribs dropped down, tummy relaxed, so that you can create this pressure naturally. By pulling in all the time, you're positioning the cylinder of your abdominals in a way that it's impossible for it to move well. Try to sit and stand in quite an upright position so that your pelvis isn't tucked under. So you want to be quite neutral in your pelvis, and then not with your chest really lifted, but with your ribs relaxed down, so that you can see as I relax my ribs down, my back ribs here lift, and I'm making this cylinder more of a cylindrical shape rather than this, which has a very lifted front here. And again, this should be a relax of your ribs down, just like you've got a relaxed stomach. Remember, good breathing is the fundamental part of having a middle that works well, and your pelvic floor tags on to that middle that works well. If this breathing mechanism doesn't work, your pelvic floor can't work. It doesn't matter what help mechanisms you use for strengthening or stretching your pelvic floor. If the system doesn't work that the pelvic floor is part of, the pelvic floor can't be functional.